And 14-year-old Savannah has a real passion for special effects. This might creep you out a little bit. Let's find out more right now. Perfect for this time of year. Savannah Hansen is here. Hello, Savannah.
Hi.
Wonderful to have you here.
Yeah, it's exciting.
Oh, can you tell us who you brought here?
This is my younger brother, Pierce, and he came to show off the mask and what I do.
That's super cool. Pierce is like the guinea pig here today. You're making him do all this stuff, and he can't say no. I understand that. When did you get into this?
I got into it actually only a year ago, but I took some time off to focus on soccer, but then I started back up in April.
Okay, so why did you get into it initially?
I actually have no clue. I guess when I actually got into it was when I was with my mom and she was doing something, and I saw some ketchup and sunscreen, so I was like, why not try to make a wound?
Try to make a wound, right?
And prank her.
Okay. Now, are you a horror movie fan?
Yeah, I love horror movies.
Yeah.
I love watching them and then seeing how, like, trying to figure out how they do the SFX on them. And it's just like, wow.
So is that what you like about horror movies the most? The special effects?
Yeah.
The gore?
Yeah, the gore. It's like brings it all together, because without it, it's like...
You just need to see that. Okay, interesting. You are 14, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, let's talk about some of the material that you use. It's pretty simple stuff, right?
Yeah, actually, basically all I use is, as I'm talking, I'll do it on Pierce's hand.
Okay.
But I use Vaseline. Okay. I'll first put it on the area he's doing, and then I take basically this stuff, which is... my fake skin, which is Vaseline, flour, and then some coloring and fake blood.
Really? That's all it is?
Yeah. It's actually pretty easy to make.
Fake skin is easy to make.
And it's all dollar store.
Okay. So it's affordable.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So what do you do with that fake skin?
Before I put on the white fake skin, I'll put on this muscle stuff, and then just I'll place it and then just press it on to create like muscles, or like instead of doing all the painting and chain, I'll just do that.
Okay. So how long does the whole process take then? Because I see obviously before the show that you've used Pierce's arm to cut him open horrifically, and his face as well. How long did that take?
The arm, it took me about 10 minutes. That's it. 10 to 15. And then the mask, since drying, without drying it would take me about 10 minutes, but with drying it takes me about 20, since I have to dry in between layers.
Okay, so how do you plan out a wound in advance?
I actually don't.
You don't? So you don't like make a drawing first or anything like that? You just go by...
Yeah, unless it's a mask, I've never done any drawings.
Really? Okay. So what are the other techniques do you want to show us here?
Basically, after I like mess up his skin, I'll take this stuff and then just roll it really thin and shape the wound.
Okay, so what is that stuff exactly?
This is just Vaseline and flour mixed to Play-Doh consistency.
Simple as that?
Yeah.
Okay. Does it take a long time to mix that stuff up, or is that just simple as well?
Really simple.
It doesn't make a mess?
Nope.
Mom and Dad are okay with this?
Yes. I don't, sometimes if I'm doing a big one, it'll be a disaster in my little area, but besides my area, it's pretty easy.
All right, so let's see what you're continuing to do here to Pierce to make him look scary.
Yeah, basically I'll press in the fake skin along the wounds. I won't do a lot of fake skin since I don't need it. It's only to align the layers.
That's something. Okay, so what is the reaction then from, say, your friends at school?
My friends, first time I showed them, one of them said they almost puked.
Okay.
And
fair
my
reaction.
Other friends thought it was so cool that I can do it, because my other friend's an artist.
My goodness.
So she thought it was really cool that I do this instead of...
Okay, and we see some of the pictures as well of you, some of your work. Do you ever go to school with that on?
No, I can't.
Because that probably wouldn't be approved.
That would be not even close.
Okay, so is there a demand for your services right now, because we are in the Halloween season?
Since I just started, I do have an Instagram page, but so far on the day of Halloween, I'm doing my first ever job to turn people into zombies.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, so what are your future hopes then?
Go to... Cinema University, university in California. I'm actually may do a summer camp there for a week, but they have like so many Oscar nominees that I really want to go there someday.
That is super cool. So you're hoping to turn this into a career, perhaps?
Yeah, a backup career for when I either retire or after season soccer.
Yeah, got to think of retirement.
Yeah, or to help during the off season.
Of course. The durability about this, I mean, does it last all day? Can you go swimming? Should you sleep with the stuff on?
Don't sleep with it.
No.
Swimming, this isn't waterproof, but this is, but the paint will come off, mm-hmm. but it's not recommended. But this is pretty durable once dried.
Okay, amazing. Yeah, so it takes a little bit to dry,
yeah.
obviously.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, can I ask you what your favorite horror movie is?
I'm not sure because I like most of them.
Yeah, all right. Mm-hmm. Freddy or Jason?
Freddy.
I had to ask that.
Yeah.
Horror movies will totally understand.
Yeah, Freddy.
Horror movie lovers. So, Instagram, it's skin_edits_.
Yeah.
That's where people can find Savannah Hansen mm-hmm. and all of her work. Thank you very much. Savannah Pierce, good job.
Mm-hmm.
We appreciate that. Scary stuff here on daytime. Details on homes for the holidays coming up next, right here on Rogers TV.